Hello everybody, hello everybody. Please let me know if you can hear me. Trying to share the live session. Let me know if you can hear me. Hello everybody, let me know if you can hear me. In the meantime, enjoy the music. Let me know if you can hear me. Trying to share the live session. Please let me know if you can hear me. Enjoy the music as I share the live session. Please let me know if you can hear me. Okay, good. Thank you so much, everyone. Emma, she says she can hear me. Lulu, George, yeah, team, we can hear you. Thank you so much, everyone. Please, if you know anyone who needs to hear this message, please tag them. Tag them on the comments, please. Anyone that you think needs to hear this, please tag them. In the meantime, let's listen to some music. I can hear you. Thank you, Frida. Tunakusikiza. Thank you so much. Please tag everyone that you know that needs to hear this message today. Please tag everyone that you know needs to hear this message today. Please tag them. Tag them here. Tag them. Tag all of them. They need to hear this message. Please tag all of them. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone. Please tag everyone that you think needs to hear this message today. Thank you so much. All right. Thank you so much, everyone, for joining this session today. I'm very happy to see everyone. I can see Dan, I can see Silas, I can see Joseph, I can see Yemi. Please tag everyone that you think needs to hear this message today. I can see Lulu George, I can see Jackie Kedenji. Thank you so much. I can see Tim. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much. Today we are going to talk about how you can come to the US as a student and get the funding. All right? How you can come to the US as a student and get the funding. All right. Are we together? Please, if you are together, say yes, you are together. Please say yes, you are together. If you can hear me, say yes, you are together. Today, we are going to see how you can come to the US as a student. Okay. You don't have to worry about what your financial background is. Okay. We need to figure out today, how can you come and study in the US? All right. I came to the US as a student. I know what it takes. All right. I came as a master's student. Anyone out there, Most of the people, they know my story. I came to the US as a master's student. I know the struggles. Okay. I know the struggles. And today I want to share with you that information. I told you before, anyone who is on my platform, I want to give value to your lives. All right. There's a lot of people who don't know about this information. A lot of people, they lack the information that they need, okay, to make this kind of decision to come to study in the US, okay? I'm sharing this information with you guys. I'm sharing this information with you. Please tag anyone that you feel that needs to listen to this. Please tag anyone that you feel needs to listen to this, okay? All right, I told you I came to the US 10 years ago. I came as a master's student. I struggled a lot. Okay, guys, I'm going to be telling you all my struggles. Okay, I struggled a lot. Okay, I mean, I'm not saying struggling in the sense of, you know, getting school fees and all that, but there's a lot of challenges. A lot of challenges that international students face when they come to this country. Okay. I'm here to give you all those tips that can help you come to the US, graduate, and actually get a job and stay here for as long as you want to. Okay? All right? Now, so today we are going to talk about how you can actually find funding to come to the US. All right? Okay, for those who don't know me, my name is Bob Mwiti. All right? I'm the founder and managing director of Upstack America. All right, and I used to work as a consultant. I've worked as a consultant for so many years. All right, since I've been in the US, since I graduated, I used to work as an IT consultant. All right, I teach people to become consultants. All right, in IT. Okay, and I was recognized by Kenyans in the diaspora as one of the most inspiring men out there, the top 40 men who are inspiring in 2018. Okay, so that's a little bit about me for those who don't know me. Okay, so we're gonna go deep into our today's discussion. All right, and for anyone who can't see my bag, my whiteboard, please let me know. I have my whiteboard over there. I can move it a little bit farther. If you have a pen and paper, you can write down. Okay, you don't want to miss out on these things, guys. All right, you don't want to miss out on these things. Okay, now, how do you find funding to come to the US? Okay, first of all, schools here in the US, they are not cheap. Okay, schools here, they are not very cheap. You cannot compare the college, what you pay for college here with what you can pay back in your home country, especially if you're coming from Africa, okay? Our college, our school system there, it's a little bit cheaper compared to here. But here's the thing, there's tons and tons of opportunities when you come to the US and study in the US, okay? Especially when you graduate, especially when you have someone who actually shows you what you need to do. Okay, guys, remember, a lot of people, they come to this country and they struggle because they lack the information. They lack someone who can show them the way. Okay, when I was coming to the US, I didn't really know how to go about these things. I was just doing things on my own. Okay, and I'm here for you guys to show you the way, to show you how to move from one step all the way to the end. Okay. Now, when it comes to now affording college here, okay, you know, we've said that, you know, it's expensive. It's not very cheap. I mean, it's schools here, okay, they cost probably maybe like five times more what it would cost you in your country. Okay. But that doesn't mean that you can't really come and study in the US. Okay. All right. Now, there's funding out there that you can actually look for. Okay. That can help you pay for your school fees. Okay. Now, there's scholarships, there's international student loans. Okay, international student loans. Guys, listen and listen carefully. All right. Now, when you come here to the US, when you come to the US, the local US students, they get funding from the US government. Okay, they get federal funding. All right. But as an international student, you do not qualify for federal funding. Okay. What are the other ways that you can qualify for funding? And that's what we're going to discuss today. International student loans. International student loans, guys. I'm going to discuss that with you today. All right. Very, very important. Okay. International student loans. Now, the problem is a lot of people, they don't even know that international student loans exist. They don't know about these things. Okay, they don't know about these things. I didn't even know that was something that like international student loans when I was out there, when I was still a student. Okay, I came to know this later on. Okay, when I became an employer. All right, and I started seeing the problems people face when they come to me and start telling me, oh, you know what, I've dropped out of school. Oh, can you please guide me? Can you give me advice on what I need to do? Okay, so I went ahead and did my own research. Okay. And found out these international student loans. Okay. Now, if you are coming, let's say for example, I'm going to be talking about master's student because I came to the US as a master's student. Okay. So, but if you want to come as an undergrad, it still applies to undergrad student, most of these things, but I'll mostly talk about master's student. Okay. I'll be biased more into the master's because I came to the US as a master's student. Okay. Now, one source of funding is international student loans. Okay, I'm gonna talk about international student loans. I'm gonna talk about scholarships. Okay, I'm gonna talk about all those two. All right, international student loans. How can you find them and who provides these loans? Okay, now, international student loans, these are loans given to international students out there even before. Says low connection. Please let me know if you can hear me because I see my connection says low network connection, but let me know if you can hear me. Okay. Now, international student loans, these are loans given to international students when you are still out there in your country, even before you get here in the US. Okay. Assume you've applied to college. Okay. You've gotten, you've applied to college. You haven't gotten the approval yet. Okay. And you need to show that because mostly what happens is this. When you do an application to a college to come and study, they will still, for them to accept you, they will need to know how you're going to get your funding. Okay. For whatever you want to do. Okay. Now, with international student loans, okay, when you get international student loans, you can use those international student loans as part of your application so that you can be accepted. All right? Now, these loans are given to just international students, okay? And you pay, the interest that is paid is very low, it's not that much, okay? You can pay once you graduate. Some of these loans, they give you grace period, okay? They give you grace period to repay after you graduate. Some of them, they give like 6 months grace period, okay? I'm gonna talk about them. One of the best international student loans out there, okay? And you can get these loans when you're still in your country. You don't have to be here, all right? It's called Empower. Empower, let me try to move so that you guys can see everything, okay? Empower, Empower Financing, all right? This is a financial institution. Okay, we partner with them as Upstack America. We have our program. We call it the Kenya Airlift Program. We try to bring brilliant students from Kenya to come and study here. And also, once they're done with their studies here, we try and look for them to look for jobs. We try to look for jobs for them. Okay, so Empower Finance, guys, you need to Google. Go and Google this information. Empower Financing, they provide international student loans. Now, these loans that Empower Financing provide, these are unsecured loans, especially if you're a master's student. Please listen and listen carefully. Okay. These are unsecured loans to international students. Okay. All right. To master's students who are, of course, international students. These are unsecured loans. So, for example, Empower Financing, what they normally do is, if you're graduating within 2 years, you can apply for their loans. Okay? They give up to $50,000. they give up to $50,000, guys, unsecured loans from Empower Financing. All right, unsecured loans for master's students. Okay, even for undergrad students, as long as when you're applying, you are supposed to be graduating within 2 years. So for master's student, because a master's program normally takes around 1 year, 1.5, you qualify for this kind of loan. Okay, and you can repay the loan after you graduate. Okay, you start repaying the loan after you graduate. Okay, all right, so Empower Financing, this is one. Okay, unsecured loans, Progyday Finance. Okay, and by the way, another thing, these, sorry about that, let me turn this off. These are loan financing institutions. They partner with schools, so it's not just any school. If you want to apply to a school, it's not just any school that you can apply to. They partner with certain schools, okay, for them to be able to give you these loans. All right, okay. So it's not just any school. If you want to go to a certain school and that school don't partner with these lenders, then you cannot get the loans. Okay, let's be clear. All right. So there's another one, Progyday Finance. Okay, these also, they provide unsecured loans. Okay, unsecured loans, especially for master's students. Also, they have a list of schools that they partner with. Okay, so you go online, go to Progyday Finance and search them, and then you'll also find the schools that partner with them. Okay, I told you, if you're coming for a master's program, if you're coming for master's, you can get unsecured loans. Unsecured when you are still in your country, okay? When you are still in your country, you'll get unsecured loans and you'll be able to apply to school, because you'll use that loan for your application to the school that you want to go to. And what they do is they send that loan to the school. They won't send loan to you because they don't know whether you can come here or not, okay? They will send the loan directly to the school, okay? Are we together? They'll send the loan directly to the school that they partner with. Okay, go to Google, Progyday Finance, Empower Financing. Okay, like I told you, we partner with Empower Financing. It's a very, very good lender. All right. Now, there is another one, Sallie Mae. Okay, Sallie Mae. All right. These ones, for you to get loans through Sallie Mae, you have to have a cosigner. Who is a cosigner? A cosigner is basically someone who can sign a loan for you as a guarantor. All right? So if you have one, and that person has to be like a permanent resident or a U.S. citizen. Okay? If a lot of us have, relatives in the U.S., okay? If you want this kind of loans, and you are reaching out to Sallie Mae, they will ask you to find a cosigner who can cosign the loans for you. All right, so that's another option, but that one requires you to have a cosigner. The first two that I've talked about, Empower, Project, those ones you don't really need a cosigner. Are we together? You don't really need a cosigner, and especially if you are coming for a master's program, these are the loans that you need to take. These are the loans that you need to take, right? Ascent Tuition. Okay, that's another one. Also, this one, it requires a cosigner. This one requires a cosigner, all right? So the same thing with Sallie Mae, all right? If you're looking for these ones, you have to know someone who is a permanent resident or a citizen who can cosign the loan for you, all right? There is another one, Discover Student Loans. Okay, these guys also, they give international student loans to international students. But also this one you also need a cosigner, all right? So the first two that I talked about, Empower Financing, Progyday Finance, those ones you don't need any cosigner, all right? You don't need any collateral, no security at all, okay? And you apply at the comfort of your house, okay? Go online, okay? You apply, all right? You go there and you apply and you will get a decision, all right? Now, one thing about these loans, especially when you are doing application for Empower Financing, Progyday, you have to, because the schools that they partner with, these are kind of like top schools, you know, state universities. These are really good schools, okay? You need, let's say, for example, if you're coming for your master's, if you're coming for an MBA or maybe an MSc or whatever it is, and you have to be, because normally when you're coming for a master's, if you're coming for a master's to those good schools, like top schools out there, state universities, you have to do some entrance exams. Normally GMAT or GRE. I'm gonna talk about these exams later on for those who may want to know about this, okay? So, if you want to get into these schools, okay, you have to do well in the GMAT, because these schools, they ask, most of these schools, they ask for example, for a GMAT score of around 550, okay? The maximum GMAT score is 800. Okay, but some of these schools that partner with Empower Financing Prodigy, they last for a GMAT that is nothing below 550. Okay, why? Because also when these lenders, Empower and Prodigy, when they're giving you those unsecured loans, they want to give to someone who actually will be able to get a job. Okay, they don't just give to anyone out there just like that. Okay, you have to be smart. Okay, anyone can come to the US and do a degree, but how can they get a job? Okay, you see, the way that these lenders look at is if you're smart, if you're someone who has gone to a good school, okay, and you have a you've applied for a good program to study, your chances of getting employed are high. Okay, that's why they'll give you these unsecured loans, okay, because you have a good, if you have a good GMAT score, okay, and you've been accepted to these schools, you have a high chance of being employed after graduating. Okay, that's why these loans, they are not just for anyone out there. Okay, you have to be smart, you have to be good. So, for example, I said you have to score a GMAT score of 550 out of 800. Okay, all right, we are together. Okay, now, other than loans, now, how else can you get funding? All right. You can actually get funding through scholarships, all right? Normally, but normally scholarships, they are usually very they are very competitive, all right? And you also have to find out where to find scholarships, okay? I'll give you a link after this live broadcast. I'll give you a link of where you can actually go and search for scholarships. Actually, I can say it's internationalstudent.com. Go to internationalstudent.com and then search there. There'll be somewhere where it says scholarships, and you can be able to search for scholarships out there in the world. Okay, but with the problem with scholarships is the competition is very, very high. So you're most likely not will not be able to get them. Okay, but anyways, it's good to try. Okay, you can't say, oh, you know what? I don't know how to do it because it's out there. You go apply and then see how it works. Okay, if you are lucky, you can get it. Okay, see all the requirements and then submit your application. All right. Now, another thing with scholarship is this. These lenders that I've talked about, Empower Financing and Prodigy Finance, they also provide scholarships to international students. Okay, if you go to their website, Empower Financing. Prodigy Finance, do you have scholarships? Okay, and there are deadlines for those scholarships. Okay, so you go there and apply for the scholarships. If you get it, well and good. Okay, that's another source of your funding for your study here in the here in the US. Okay, now I told you that, like for example, Empower Financing, they finance you up to $50,000. Okay, so if you come to a for a master's program here, you can actually have everything covered for every single thing. All right? And the good thing is with Empower Financing, they also provide you with the letter to take. They back you up. They provide you with documentation and the letters to take to the US Embassy when you are going to apply for your visa. Okay? You will have a letter from them saying that they are the ones who are funding your education. Basically, a support letter, okay, to the embassy, all right, and also they, of course, they're gonna provide the funding. They're gonna channel the funds to the school directly, okay. So you will take that to your embassy, and then now when you go to the embassy, you need all you need to tell them is I've been funded by this lender, by this, by this, by this. Now, the about US visa embassy interview and stuff like that. Sorry about that. Let me try to. Something is trying to give me warning here. So when you go to the US embassy, you need to prepare for visa interviews and all that. I will talk about this later on, okay, in some of my my live sessions. All right. Now, another way that you can get funding is through, if you are coming as a master's student, you can get funding working as a graduate assistant. I used to get this funding, all right? But also you need to do very well in school, okay? Before you even come to the US, if you find a school, okay, you can actually ask them if they provide graduate assistantship, okay? This is how it works. So normally schools, they provide this kind of help, okay, financial help to international students who are smart, like who are scoring, doing well in class, okay? So they will provide you with funding, they will pay part of your school fees or tuition, and then also they'll give you a job to work as a graduate assistant. Those who come here as master's student, I used to have that job. Very nice job. You work with a professor. You'll be like, if you're a master's student, you'll be working with a professor in their department. You can help out with, you know, doing research. You can help out with invigilating, like, you know, exams for undergrad students, stuff like that. Okay. Very nice job. And they pay you. Most of them, they pay like $10 an hour, which is good for a student. Okay, $10 an hour. They give you work. Like you can work like 20 hours a week. And then also they pay for your school fees. Okay, so when you do those applications, the school, ask them about graduate assistantship. Okay, ask them. Okay, and they will pay for your tuition. Okay, some of them, they pay full tuition. Okay, and others, they'll pay half. For me, when I was a master's student, I used to get half paid scholarship, graduate assistantship. Okay, they will pay half of my school fees from the second semester until I finish my college. All right, but you have to maintain a certain GPA. GPA is like performance. All right, so like for me, we had to maintain a 3.75 GPA for you to get funding, okay, as a graduate assistant. Okay, and it's not very hard. That means like you need to score like 3 A's and a B. Okay, in your semester, every semester. Okay, that's if you are like, if you are really, if you are focused, okay, and you know what to do. Education here, it's not very hard. Okay, if you come through our systems back there, it's very, very hard over there. Here, they give you marks for almost for free. Okay, you attend classes, they'll give you free marks. Okay, so you find scoring A's, it's not a big deal. Okay, like me, when I was doing my undergrad, okay, I went for my undergrad at Strathmore University. Scoring an A was a problem. Okay, it was a big thing. But here in the US, like scoring an A, it's like if you're not scoring an A, you feel like, you know, you feel bad. Like you have to score an A. Okay, so I mean, they require you to score, like, for example, every semester you'll need maybe like 3 A's and 1 B for you to maintain a 3.75 GPA. But it's very, very doable. Okay. All right, it's very, very doable. So you just need to be focused, okay, and know what you want. All right, so those are the ways that you can get your funding. You can get funding through Empower Loans Financing, Prodigy Finance, Sallie Mae, Accent, Discover. As far as the loans are concerned, I said also with Empower and Prodigy, you can get unsecured loans. Okay, unsecured loans, guys. All right, and then also you can find scholarships, and also you can also get graduate assistantship. All right, so please, anyone out there who may want to study, come study in the US, please tag them in this recording, okay, in this live session, and they can come and listen to this information, because information is power. All right, thank you everyone, thank you so much, and I'll see you next time. Goodbye.